Okay, so here's a quick video of a jukebox that I've got for sale. This is a 1970 Seberg Bandshell. And yeah, a pretty striking and cool jukebox, I gotta say. Yes, Nacho. Nacho really likes this thing. Yes. And anyway, I'll get to why he likes it in a minute. But yeah, so obviously, you know, a pretty striking and cool looking machine with great colors and just a really unique look. In 1970, Seberg redesigned all of their jukeboxes. They wanted to get away from, you know, what they had sort of looked like previous to that. You know, by the end of the 60s, Seberg's jukeboxes were sort of these big clunky wooden things. I mean, they were great, you know, don't get me wrong, they were charming and cool, but I guess they just wanted something with a little bit more panache, a little bit more flash, so this is what the designers and engineers put together, and yeah, it's a pretty cool looking thing. I mean, love the colors. I mean, it just screams Miami Vice. You know, it's got, well, just the pinks and the purples and the pastels, and then it's got this, you know, effect where the light shines through this onto this back panel here, and you know, depending on where you're standing, you know, it makes shadows come out. It's just cool. They're really great, unique boxes. They have the big amplifier, the Ship 3, which was the biggest one that Seberg ever made, and it's got digital controls, which I don't know if this was the first model with the digital controls, but I think it might be. If it's not, it's one of the first. So a lot of firsts on this, yeah, I've sold a few and people really like them. I like them. So anyway, yeah, and I'll tell you why Nacho likes this jukebox so much, because Nacho likes this jukebox because Nacho likes a good deal. He knows a good deal when he sees one, and this particular jukebox I am going to be letting go cheaper than I normally sell them for. I mean, it'll still have the warranty and it'll still, you know, completely serviced, amp rebuilt, mechanism, you know, taken apart, adjusted. Everything that needs to be done is done. So it's a fully functioning, good sounding jukebox with all the service performed, and there, you know, won't be any trouble with it. But it's got some cosmic bobos. Cosmic? I didn't mean that. Cosmetic bobos. This part of the jukebox, it's like a plexiglass thing. It's cracked. And I guess the previous, like the operator, whoever, you know, did their best to kind of help it along, but whatever they came up with wasn't great. So, yeah, I know. It's tragic, Nacho. Hi, yeah. Dude, I'm trying to make a video. So, yeah, so this, unfortunately, that kind of killed it for me. There's also, you know, just little small things. This isn't major, but the, you know, the art is kind of a little, it's peeling. I mean, it's minor. That's not the end of the world. The other really sort of unfortunate thing is down here. I mean, this is glass. Behind this, you know, is a piece of art that the light shines through to kind of get the effect. And, you know, this isn't broken or anything. Everything's fine. It's just, it's damaged from the inside. So, I mean, you could conceivably... Yeah, buddy, I know. You could conceivably find another piece of art and redo it. I mean, I thought about it, but, you know, there was just too many little things going on with it cosmetically. So, you know what? I mean, it's going to be offered up for sale at a lower price, and that's fine, you know? Sometimes you got to have bargains. We like deals. Deals are good. So if you want a deal, here's a deal. What else can I tell you? Well, that's really it. I mean, it looks good, sounds good. I mean, it's just, you know, a little too rough for me to spend the time that I normally would, you know, on the cosmetics. So that's it. This would be a great jukebox for someone who has a cottage, or maybe someone that has like a workshop. You know, if you've got a, like a, I see this thing in like a, if you've got a garage and you're some cool garagey guy with a workshop and, you know, you're fixing cars and you want to have a jukebox in there that you're not too worried about, well, this would be it. You know, it's going to function and look cool. And, well, if you, you know, push the buttons with dirty fingers, you know, you're not going to lose any sleep over it. So, you know, to me, that's what this is for. So anyway, before this gets too long, I'll just, well, let's see here. I'll pick a song. Why don't I do that? I don't have any title cards in it. Didn't do that. Normally we do, but I haven't in this one. Really, I mean, at this point, I'm just trying to make some space. It is clean inside. I mean, you know, I cleaned up all the, well, the, you know, a lot of these things are covered in like cigarette smoke and grossness. You know, that's been mostly taken care of. You know, it's not as clean as some of them, but you know what? That's why it's cheap. So, yeah, let's pick a song here. Just any old song. So the lights all still work, and they, you know, everything still functions. It's just, well, just a little, there's a few little bobos on it, but you know what? That's okay. So, there you go. Miami Vice. Actually, no, this isn't Miami Vice. What is this? Beverly Hills Cop. But you know what? Beverly Hills Cop works. So yeah, if you're looking for something for your cottage or your garage or shop or whatever, or if you just want a cheap, good jukebox, this is the one for you.